The last time I talked about metformin or berberine was almost 2 years ago, and a lot of new information has come out about both. So it's definitely time for a new update. And I'll also be sharing with you the reasons why I stopped taking metformin and have switched to berberine. Now, before I get into this video, I'd like to remind you guys that my online course is just about ready to launch. This is the culmination of a couple of years of work, and I'm really excited about it. It's going to be an introduction into the concepts of longevity. So if you're new to this whole field, this online course is for you. Look, I get it. Longevity science can be daunting. There's so much going on in the field right now, and most of the information that's coming out is either for other scientists or researchers. It can be difficult for us lay people to not only find the relevant information, but to understand it. Sifting through the growing mountain of data out there can be challenging. Well, I've done that for you. This course contains just the information that you need to get started on this lifelong exploration into how to live a radically longer and healthier life. Now, if you're an old hand, if you're already well into the longevity lifestyle, if you've been doing this for years and are looking for an advanced and comprehensive series of courses, that's coming down the pike. I'll be doing a series of courses for you guys in the future. But this course is for those of you who are just starting out, who have heard about the potential of the longevity movement in the news lately and want to learn more, to get your feet wet, who want to learn what you need to do to get started. This course will examine what I call the foundations of longevity, those lifestyle practices that will set you up for success, things like longevity nutrition, exercise, and sleep. Then we'll dive into longevity interventions, those strategies that have been discovered that might actually extend the human lifespan. And finally, we'll take a look at designing your own personalized longevity plan. So if this sounds exciting, click on the link up here or in the description below, send me your contact information, and I'll put you on a list of people that will receive advance notice when Introduction to Longevity is about to launch. Okay, so back about 4 or 5 years ago, metformin seemed to have great potential to extend the human lifespan. It seemed to be a longevity drug that showed a lot of promise. In 2019, Dr. Greg Fahey published the TRIM study. He used human growth hormone, DHEA, and metformin to reverse thymic involution, where the thymus gets converted to fat, reducing the amount of active thymic tissue. Now, an unexpected benefit of this experiment was that he also reversed biological age by a couple of years. In 2008, there was a mouse study that showed that they were able to extend the lifespan of mice by 37.8%. And in 2014, there was a human study that demonstrated that diabetics on metformin lived 15% longer than non-diabetics, normal people who were not on metformin. But a couple of years ago, all that started to change. First off, the 2008 mouse study was done on SHR mice. That stands for spontaneously hypertensive mice. These are inbred mice who all have high blood pressure. But in normal mice, metformin doesn't seem to have the same effect. The Interventions Testing Program tried to duplicate the 2008 experiment in 3 different trials and were unable to produce any comparable results. And in 2021, the National Diabetes Prevention Program published the results of a study that they've been conducting for 21 years. In this study, done on over 3,000 adults at risk for type 2 diabetes, half got metformin and half got placebo. In the 21-year follow-up period, there was no perceived increase in the death rates from all-cause mortality, cancer, or cardiovascular disease. No difference between metformin and the placebo. So in recent years, there just doesn't seem to be much in the way of evidence that supports the idea that metformin can extend the human lifespan. In fact, there seems to be a lot of evidence that metformin can actually produce negative effects on the human body. Now, in the last video that I did on metformin versus berberine, I mentioned a 2019 study that looked at aerobic exercise combined with metformin. Since both metformin and exercise have beneficial effects on blood sugar, one might expect that these effects would be additive. Turns out, they're not. This study found that participants who were doing both metformin and exercise experienced 50% less improvement in their VO2 max compared to those who were on a placebo. In other words, people who were just exercising improved twice as much as people who were combining their exercise with metformin. Now, the study was controversial because of its small size, but in 2022, a more thorough study was conducted that got the same results. So it seems that the 2022 study confirmed the results of the 2019 study. Metformin seems to interfere with the effects of exercise. That's not a good thing, since exercise has more beneficial effect on aging than just about anything else. And unfortunately, that's not all. A 2021 study on humans showed that metformin has a negative impact on testosterone production. After 3 months of treatment, the control group had higher levels of total testosterone, free testosterone, and bioavailable testosterone than the metformin group. Testosterone levels in the metformin group had significantly decreased. And my own personal experience seems to corroborate a lot of this. So, as many of you know, I've been using the Regenerative Medicine Institute as one of my go-to sources for recommendations. In early 2022, the doctors there recommended that I start taking metformin. So, I did. I took metformin for a couple of months in March and April, but I didn't take it for long. First off, one of the potential side effects of taking metformin is digestive upset. And it turned out that I was one of those people susceptible to that particular side effect. It wasn't a very strong effect, but I did experience diarrhea. So around the end of April, I stopped taking metformin. Within 3 days of quitting metformin, once it was out of my system, I saw a big improvement in my workout sessions. It was easier to get through the session, and I wasn't nearly as wiped out once I finished. After a couple of weeks, I felt like I was back on track, that I was making improvement in my fitness level. So that was pretty persuasive for me that my body did not respond very well to metformin. Okay, so that's why I quit taking metformin. Science just didn't seem to indicate that there was any apparent benefit in aging, but there was a massive negative impact on my ability to exercise and any improvements in my fitness levels. But RMI had recommended that I take metformin, or at least a CR mimetic, and this still seemed like a good idea. Calorie restriction is still one of the few proven ways to extend lifespans, and I'm well aware of the negative impact that glucose spikes can have on my health. Now, I'm already doing a lot of other things to control my blood sugar levels. Mostly, I control it through my diet, but also with intermittent fasting and exercise. But taking a CR mimetic seems like it could have an additive effect on all the other things that I'm already doing. So I decided to switch to berberine. Now, the first thing I wanted to know was, are there any studies that seem to demonstrate that berberine has a positive impact on the aging process? The internet is full of studies and articles that seem to support this. And more importantly, unlike metformin, I couldn't find any literature that seems to counteract or disprove any of this. A study published in July of 1922 showed that berberine can slow signs of aging in heart cells, decreasing cellular senescence. Now, interestingly enough, it also showed that many of the beneficial effects of berberine require clotho, an anti-aging protein associated with extending lifespans. And a mouse study published in January of this year shows that berberine can improve both spatial learning and memory in mice with cognitive decline. Now, this is just a couple of papers or articles that I found on the anti-aging properties of berberine, but there are a lot more. Okay, so anti-aging properties, check. But does it have any negative impact on exercise, like metformin? Well, apparently not. In this study from 2019, they tested elderly men who were healthy, but sedentary and overweight. They broke them into four groups. One that did circular training, which they defined as resistance and interval training. Another group that supplemented with berberine, a third group that did both, and a fourth group was a control group. After 8 weeks, they found that combining circular training with berberine supplementation resulted in higher levels of cardiovascular improvement in overweight men than either circular training or berberine supplementation alone. So it looks like berberine not only does not cancel out exercise like metformin, but actually has an additive effect. That's just what I wanted to hear. And my own personal experience seems to back this up so far. On my last trip down to RMI, the good doctors there recommended that I take berberine instead of metformin. So I've been taking berberine for a couple of months now, and I've experienced none of the negative effects of taking metformin. I've experienced no digestive upset, and my ability to perform during workouts doesn't seem to be impacted whatsoever. I've got plenty of energy to finish my workouts, and I'm not wiped out at the end. And as near as I can tell, in the 2 months that I've been taking berberine, I've still been able to continue making progress in my fitness, endurance, and stamina levels. So, all in all, I'm pretty happy with my experience on berberine. Okay, that wraps up this latest video on metformin and berberine. If you'd like to learn more about longevity supplements and medications, watch this playlist. And don't forget, sign up to be notified when my online course, Introduction to Longevity, is about to launch. That's it for me. I'm out of here. See you next time.